Here's another problem about continuity. We're asked to determine the interval or intervals on which the following function is continuous. And our function in this case is a rational function. F of x equals 7x squared plus 3x plus 1 all over the quantity x squared minus 9. First of all, what do we know about the continuity of rational functions in general? Well, there's a theorem about the continuity of rational functions that states that rational functions are continuous everywhere except at those points that make the denominator equal to 0. So then what we should probably start by doing is determining if this rational function has any x values which make the denominator 0. And to do that, it's going to be helpful to factor the denominator. So let's go ahead and do that. In my denominator here, I have what's called a difference of squares, x squared minus 9. So that's going to factor into x plus 3 times x minus 3. So then we can see once we factor that there are going to be two x values that would make the denominator 0, specifically x equals 3 or x equals negative 3. So these are going to be points where our function f of x is not continuous. Now in some of our other videos on continuity, we've talked about the idea of continuous from the left, or left continuous, and continuous from the right at endpoints. So we maybe just want to make sure to ask ourselves a question. Could this function f of x be left or right continuous at either x equals 3 or x equals negative 3? So to answer that question, it would of course be helpful to remember the definition of left or right-hand continuity. So we know that f of x is continuous from the left at some point x equals a if the limit is x goes to a from the left of f of x equals f of a. And then there's a similar definition for right-hand continuity, except of course we're looking at the limit as x goes to a from the right. So based on these definitions, can we say that our function is left or right continuous at x equals 3 or x equals negative 3? And the answer is no. And the reason is that our function does not even exist at x equals 3 or x equals negative 3. These values give us a 0 in the denominator of this rational function, which means our function isn't defined there. It just doesn't exist. So the limit can't equal f of a if f of a doesn't exist. So our function is not left or right continuous at either of these points. It's just completely discontinuous there. So then, once again, we know that our function is continuous everywhere except at x equals 3 and x equals negative 3. So then we can go ahead and write down our final answer, which are going to be the intervals on which this function is continuous. So basically, I'm just going to include all numbers except 3 and negative 3. So my function is continuous from negative infinity to negative 3, and it's also continuous from negative 3 to positive 3, and then finally, it's also continuous from positive 3 to positive infinity. So those are the intervals on which my function is continuous. And let me verify this for you by looking at a graph of this function. So here I've plotted a graph of our rational function, and notice I have these dotted vertical lines at x equals negative 3 and x equals 3. These are vertical asymptotes for this function. But then everywhere else we can see that our function is continuous. So we said it was continuous first of all on the interval from negative infinity to negative 3. That's this piece of the function here, right? This piece is continuous. And then we also have a continuity on the interval from negative 3 to 3. Right, that's this piece of the function in the middle here. And then finally, we have continuity on the interval from 3 to positive infinity. You see that on this piece of the function over here.